when I first started playing Irish music some years ago, I came from a background as a jazz piano and keyboard player, and I figured I needed to learn another instrument, one that was a bit more handy to bring down to the pub. And after a while, I landed on the piano accordion as my main instrument in this journey through the world of traditional music. Now, if I could go back, would I still choose the same instrument again? Let me explain. So, I've been playing the piano accordion for a good few years now, and feels like I'm slowly starting to get the hang of it. Although, I have to say, it has been times where I really just wanted to chuck the box in the lake and be done with it. Obviously, I made it kinda hard for myself, trying to learn a totally new genre of music and a new instrument at the same time. I do still think that the piano accordion has some unique challenges to it when it comes to Irish and Celtic trad. Up until fairly recently, I feel like piano accordion players have been looked down upon a bit in the trad community. As for many people, the real Irish accordion is the button accordion. Now, did I mention this would be a seriously nerdy video? It'll only get worse from here, so if you for some reason aren't into this sort of stuff, you're welcome to tune back in next week, as I have something a bit different planned for that video. Now, to kick off this little rant about piano accordions, I'm gonna give you four reasons why you shouldn't really play the piano accordion in Irish and Celtic music. Reason number one, it's kinda big. I always get envious at sessions when I meet fiddle players and flute players and even concertina players who could just pack their instruments down to almost nothing. And this isn't even a big piano accordion. Reason number two, it's not very cool, unfortunately. And I always have a hard time posing with it in band photos and stuff. Like, it's just too big and clunky and awkward. I usually end up just carrying it over my shoulder like this. Yeah. Reason number three, you will always get compared to button accordion players. And I often get compliments like, yeah, that sounded really nice. I almost thought you were playing a button accordion there. Thanks. And reason number four, on a slightly more serious note, is that this instrument isn't really very idiomatic to the music. You see, Irish and Celtic music was more or less invented on the fiddle and the bagpipes and a few other instruments. And therefore it fits those instruments really well. For example, you tend to find a lot of big intervals, like fifths and octaves. And on a fiddle, that isn't necessarily that tricky to play. And even on the button accordion, because the buttons are fairly small and you even have two notes on each button, the physical space that you need to move your fingers within to produce the notes aren't really that big. Whereas on this thing, for me, an octave is quite a stretch. So that's why when you see piano accordion players playing reels at a fairly fast tempo, it looks really ridiculous. And you can clearly see that this is not the most efficient way to produce these notes. Now, joking aside, there are many players that make the piano accordion sound wonderful in Irish and Celtic music, so there's no excuse really. And I suppose all instruments have their advantages and disadvantages. Over the years, I like to think that I have developed a personal style on the instrument by drawing inspiration from different players and listening to different instruments. And I thought I would just quickly show you some of the techniques that I use in my playing. So I'm basically just gonna give up on color grading in this next segment because the light outside kept changing a lot and I must have had a weird setting on my camera or something, so it'll be black and white from here. Sorry about that. So Irish music is mainly a melodic musical tradition, and I focused most of my attention on getting the melodies to sound right on the piano keyboard. But I will talk a little bit about the bass side of the accordion in the end. Now I'm gonna run through some of the ornaments that I use in my playing. And if you're not super familiar with Irish and Celtic music yet, ornaments is basically techniques we use to color the melody, if you will, and make it more interesting. And the most important thing is obviously to be able to play the melodies with a strong, steady rhythm. But I find that you really need to master these ornaments to be able to make the tunes sound authentic, if you will. The first ornament I'm going to demonstrate is called a cut. And a cut is basically a very short note played in front of the main note. And because it's so short, it can basically be any note, really. Sounds like this. find that I most of the time use either the note directly above the main note or a third above, although sometimes I also use the fifth above. It's slightly different colors. This next ornament is very common on the flute and the fiddle, and it's called a roll. It's a bit more tricky to execute properly on the piano keyboard, so I don't really use it that much, but it's basically done by playing a short note before the main note, and a note half step below. So. As I said, this is one of the trickier ornaments to play on the piano accordion, and I'm still working on how I can use it as effectful as possible. This next ornament I don't really have a name for, but I've picked it up from listening to button accordion players, and it is basically cutting with the main note and then cutting with the note a third above before hitting the main note, so it would sound something like this. Fairly similar to a standard cut, but it has a rolling quality to it that I really enjoy. The last ornament I'm gonna show you is called a triplet or a treble, and it is a fairly easy ornament to execute on the piano keyboard, and piano accordion players tend to use it a lot. Kind of overused in my opinion, but I do use it a lot myself, so here it is. It's basically the same note played three times fairly quickly. And what's handy is that you can use three different fingers for this, so it'll look something like this. Now, this might sound impressive if you haven't tried it before, but as I said, it comes fairly natural to the piano keyboard. The only thing to watch out for is that for the longest time I used to think that the three notes should be even. But ideally, the first note should be much quicker, almost like a cut. So it's almost like you're playing two notes and cutting the first. So in reality, something like this. So this makes it a bit more tricky to play, but in my opinion, it also makes it a lot more crispy and nice. Finally, I'm going to talk briefly about my approach to the bass side of the accordion. As I said earlier in the video, I'm coming from a background as a piano player, so this side of the instrument has always been a bit of a mystery to me, and I don't practice it nearly as much as I should, I guess. To be honest, my bass playing is a bit shit, but when I do use it, I tend to draw inspiration more from button accordion players and use it more to provide accents and complementing the melody in a way, more than playing a accompaniment. So it would sound something like this. So that's the basics of my approach to Irish music on the piano accordion, and I'm constantly working on developing my style, so I might look into some more interesting bass work in the future, for example, but this is how it sounds at the moment. I'm curious to know if this is something you enjoy watching, so I'd be really grateful for your feedback. It got a bit nerdy today, but as I said, I have something a bit different planned for next week, so hope to see you again then, and take care.